वेरी वार्म नमस्ते टू ऑल रिस्पेक्टेड डिग्नेटरीज एंड वेरी गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन. प्लीज एक्सेप्ट माय हार्टफेल्ट ग्रेटिट्यूड फॉर द वंडरफुल अपॉर्चुनिटी टू बी हियर अमंग द डिग्नेटरीज फॉर द योगा डे सेलिब्रेशन. आई एम शेयरिंग माय थॉट्स ऑन पेंडेमिक एंड आयुर्वेदिक अप्रोच. आयुर्वेदा एज द नेम सजेस्ट इटसेल्फ इज द साइंस ऑफ लाइफ. द गोल इज समराइज्ड एज स्वस्थस्य स्वास्थ्य रक्षणम आतुरस्य व्याधि परिमोक्षा मीन्स प्रिवेंशन एंड ट्रीटमेंट दैट स्पीक्स द नॉट ओनली क्यूरिंग द इलनेस बट ऑल्सो डिस्क्राइब्स एज द हेल्थ एंड वेज टू मेंटेन प्रैक्टिकली. आयुर्वेदा क्लियरली डील्स विद द डिसीज इट्स मेडिकल सर्जिकल एंड डिटॉक्सिफिकेशन मॉडर्निटीज फॉर प्रिवेंशन डिसीजेस and also importance and various through various way keeping one's body mind and soul equilibrium. The ancients call and in Ayurveda the about epidemic is mentioned by Acharya Charaka in the Charaka Sanhita chapter 3 about the as a Janapadodhansa chapter means Janapadodhansa destruction of community through various diseases. The ancient Ayurveda scholars were all aware of the spread of the epidemic. Charak Sanhita as well as many subsequent books given its details. Certain diseases are transmitted from one person to another person by direct or indirect contacts. While another group of diseases are born from the common source of polluted air, water, land, even with the imbalance in the climate conditions. Together, they are classified as the Janapadodhansa Vyadhis, diseases of the epidemic. Ayurveda warns of Janapadodhansa consequences as term adharma, in natural things, as its root causes. That is, behaving against the rules of nature or offending the ecological balances. All great ancient Indian books have references of epidemics, the Janapadodhansa. Ayurveda stated the root causes of the epidemic as follows: prajnaparadha, mistakes of the intellect against the sub-classified as a dhi, ignorance, dhriti, lack of awareness, smriti, mistakes caused by not remembering the cautions. The second one is asatmendriya, or the sanyoga, improper contact or senses with their objects. That means consuming everything in a wrong way, which creates overstimulation and deficiency of sensory element ultimately, resulting into imbalance.
Thank you very, very much,
One moment.
Professor. I'm very humbly interrupting you in what you're sharing, as even on another timeline, time doesn't exist, but here in the Gregorian time, 3 minutes are just over.